The simpler it is, the better I like it. Peter Lynch. That is a great quote from Mr. Lynch, and he is exactly right. That's what we focus on here at chartingwealth.com, keeping it simple. And as Einstein said, keep it as simple as possible, not simpler. And of course, as John Occam of Occam's Razor, the Franciscan friar from many centuries ago, told us over and over again, basically the more moving parts you have, the more complicated you make something, the more flaws you're going to have in it. So again, keep it simple. That's what we do here. We trend follow. We don't guess. We don't gamble. We follow established trends. That's what we look for. And again, that's what we are all about. And things are getting more and more dangerous as we continue to see the market move up, up, up. Just crazy. Today, everything up, the highest up for the day, gold. Gold up over 2.5%. Bonds up, stocks up almost 1% on each of our indexes. Very interesting to see things that ought to be running in opposite directions. Typically, when the market's up, bonds typically go down. Gold might go down too because they're seen as safe havens when stocks aren't doing well. Stocks pounding up, gold flying up super high. And of course, there are reasons folks can give you for all of these things. And some of them are true, some of them are guesses, but everything is a little scary. When we start looking at what corporate earnings are, we start looking at what's actually backing up this inflationary, continued inflationary move in the market, we don't see a lot there. And again, that is why we tell you to be prepared when the market does tumble over, and it will, it always does. It's going to be bloody, it's going to be nasty, and you're going to need to be liquid and able to move and capture that hammer down. So how do we see the S&P as we get toward the end of the week? Looks like we might have another weekly vertical crossover going up after a very short period of time. Folks, that is not what we like to see here at all, and that is not what we see going back a couple of years. We see nice clean movements up, clean movements down. We don't like seeing a down move immediately followed just 4 weeks later by an up move. Really just 2 weeks, well, just a full week after our prior down move. That is not healthy. That is not what we should be seeing. That is what gives us fear and concern. We see that the price percent oscillator is crossing over the signal line, reaching a higher high than it did the prior time. And look at the divergence here of where our price percent oscillator is as compared to where the price is. Don't like seeing that. Don't like seeing things without legs to support the up movement. So again, we're going to let the charts guide us, but we're also going to have some trepidation as to what is actually going on. Now, we're entering into some dangerous territory. See things peaking up where they did a few weeks ago when the market was reaching super highs. Again, concerning to us, very concerning. So we may very well by the end of the week have another weekly vertical crossover going up, entering some uncharted territory there. What's going on the two-day chart? It's flying up. It crossed over going up back on Wednesday the 12th. Bit of a pullback that next two-day candle, and then the last 4 days, strong up movement, price well above the two-day trend line, derivative oscillator gaining upward momentum. Go from the two-day to the four-hour. And of course, we saw things slide sideways for several days and then start pounding up on Tuesday and just continuing to pound up, going above the Bollinger Bands, both in the morning and the afternoon on Thursday. So again, concerns here about this volatility and these swings. We shall see where they lead us. Up 0.96% the S&P 500. Go to the NASDAQ 100. Not to the point of crossing over yet. Still strong up moves over the last 2 weeks. We see the derivative oscillator is still negative, you know, and again, check out on the S&P 500 where the derivative oscillator is. Still negative as the price percent oscillator is crossing over. We don't like that either. We like for our crossovers to occur at the same time. Not a good sign that we have a crossover potentially occurring before the derivative oscillator is ready for it. That's on the S&P 500. NASDAQ 100, again, hasn't crossed, doesn't look like it's going to be crossing. Keep your eye on things, up candle. Go from the weekly to the two-day. What do we see there? We see that the two-day, of course, crossed over going up back on Friday, the 14th. And these last 4 days, strong up movement, derivative oscillator gaining upward momentum, price percent oscillator heading up. What does the four-hour chart show us? Again, we saw a sideways slide, not as long as the S&P 500. Things started moving up on Monday the 17th and have been moving up since then, popping up and then sideways and popping up on Tuesday, sideways on Wednesday, popping up on Thursday. Bit of a pullback toward the end of the day. Again, derivative oscillator heading up, price percent oscillator heading up. Keep your eyes on these stocks. Let's see what's really going on. And again, same kind of divergence here. You know, we saw where the price percent oscillator maxed out back on the top price on Friday the 3rd of May. And then we see things trundling down for 5 weeks and now back up, hitting where it had previously. So again, concerns. We'll continue to be concerned. We'll watch the charts and let them lead us. What do we see going on 20-year bonds? Bonds continue to move up. Another up week in bonds. Price percent oscillator heading up. Derivative oscillator gaining upward momentum. Go from the weekly to the two-day. Two-day chart, again, heading up over the last 6 days after they slid sideways for about 6 days, reaching a higher high than it had previously. Price percent oscillator heading up. Derivative oscillator about flat, maybe losing a little bit of energy. Go to that four-hour chart. What do we see? Of course, we had that four-hour rather weak crossover heading up. We saw it bounce down to the red signal line and then take back off again on Wednesday. Then it was up substantially on Thursday morning, a little bit of a pullback on Thursday afternoon. Of course, those of you who jumped in like I did on a trade there on Wednesday with a great deal of trepidation, since we had seen the derivative oscillator crossover way back. I don't like that. But again, we had that price percent oscillator pull away from the red signal line. Nice pop up in the morning, some weakness in the afternoon. Of course, we'll continue to keep our eye on that two-day chart, which is heading up, and that weekly chart, which is heading up strongly. So we'll keep our eye on things, up 0.26% for the day. Of course, the biggest up move for the day, gold, with that weekly vertical crossover going back to the 7th of June, that Friday. Up week last week, huge up week this week, particularly as to what occurred on Thursday, up 2.25%, spiking up almost vertical. Derivative oscillator gaining lots of momentum, price percent oscillator heading up. Go to the two-day chart. What do we see there on gold? We see a huge spike up. The candle on the wick on top is the length of the candle itself. Amazing. Just shoving well above the Bollinger Bands, the volatility bands. And again, that spike, hockey stick spike going up in the price percent oscillator, derivative oscillator gaining upward momentum. And of course, what about that four-hour chart? Well, we had waited and waited. You know, we had the crossover, the weekly vertical crossover back on Friday the 7th, and then things went down for a day and a half. Then went up for several days, down for a day and a half. Then, I mean, really just sort of down and sideways, some up movement over the course of time. But then, of course, we never had the price percent oscillator go positive for us. Derivative oscillator went positive back on the 18th. And then, of course, this morning is where we had the huge bump up. How many of you jumped into gold this afternoon? Who were the brave ones that jumped in and rode that up? Again, If you did not, no harm, no foul in that. Wait and see how things take off tomorrow and what things look like. And if you can find a jumping in point, I'm always worried when we see crazy spikes up in things. And I understand if some of you had trepidation, but those of you who were brave and pulled the trigger on that, please make sure you're filling out your trade worksheets. You are learning from what you're doing. Same with those who pulled the trigger with me on 20-year bonds, TLT, back a day and a half or so ago. We'll see how that works out for us. And again, continue to watch this market, wondering how long the legs are in stocks. Dangerous, scary times. Those of you who've been through this before, you know what I am talking about, wondering where the legs are. And again, I know that the Fed speak and all of that's having a lot to do with this, but I love to see things supported by the charts so we have a more comfortable feeling as to what is actually going on. If you haven't purchased our book, we have autographed copies available, sent out a bunch of international copies today. You'll see a link in the show notes to purchase the book. If you happen to live overseas, do email us, cw@chartingwealth.com. For some reason, Square will not allow you to use a foreign credit card. We'll send you an invoice. You can pay it with a credit card through PayPal or through your PayPal account. Again, if you live in the States, see the link in the show notes. We love to hear from you. Those of you who are subscribers, of course, you received yesterday morning the first weekly question and answer session that we recorded and sent out. We love to have your questions. Send them to us. We'll attempt to answer all of them as we go through our weekly, bi-weekly Q&A sessions we're going to send out to all the subscribers. How do you subscribe? It's absolutely free. Go to chartingwealth.com. Sign up. We don't spam that list. Nobody gets your email address but us. God bless my friends. All the best from the whole team here at Charting Wealth World Headquarters. Keep the faith. You can do this. Remember, this is a summertime trading zone. It's the suckiest time of year. So we're doing all that we can to continue practicing, continue learning. Fall winter trading zone is on the way. It's the summer solstice tonight here on the East Coast at 7:10, longest day of the year. All the best, my friends. God bless. Take care.